Alright guys, so in the previous videos, you were introduced to the concept of directed graphs. You had seen how you can work with directed graphs using your NetworkX package. As well as, I had introduced you to this game of points distribution. So, we had seen the concepts. So, let us see, as I had said, one snap you had done the calculation. What happens if we keep repeating this? So, let us first try simulating this in Excel. That is a spreadsheet, we'll try simulating it. Because given that we are doing this for some thousand times, manually if you do, there is a possibility that after some iterations, you may get some fractions as well. So you may have some errors if you do it manually. So let us use the spreadsheet software and let us see what happens. Let me open a new sheet. I'm opening the new spreadsheet. So let us say we are starting with, we are starting with 100 points per node. We have the nodes A, B and C. Let us use the same columns for ease of understanding. We start with 100 points. So I have given 100 points to all three of them and I have asked them to exchange based on that rule. And so after exchange, what happens? We had seen what will be the new points that will be accumulated. We have seen. Let us refresh once. See, new points of A is nothing but old points of C. Just it will retain that. So what is the new value here? This is time 1. Let us say at time t equal to 1, this is the values. They had initially equal values, all 100 points each. So at time 2, what happens? What are the old points of C is what A will have. So let me say equal to C1, old points. Okay. And so what for B? What is the new points of B is half of the old points of A. So I'll say equal to old points of A is A1 here divided by 2, half, right? So that's why I'm dividing it. Okay. So for C, what is the new points? Half of old points of A plus old points of B, because C is liked by both these people. So it will get more points. So half of old points of A and old points of B, we have to add them up. So let us feed in that formula. Half of old points of A. I'll say A1 by 2 plus, what is it? Old points of B. So it's B1. Okay. So as I have said, it's 150 and 150. So this calculation, we had done it. What happens if we repeat it for further iterations? So in Excel, if you drag it, the formula will get copied automatically. It will get adjusted. That is a nice feature available in this software. So we'll drag it and see what happens. See, these are the values after some 10 iterations. So it was 150, 150. So that 150 came here. Half of it comes here. So some kind of jugglery happens. And at every point, as I have said, the sum will be constant. So sum is equal to, so let me give a space so that you can understand this is the points and this is the statistics we are calculating. Let us see, we are calculating the sum equal to A1 plus B1 plus C1. Okay, this is the sum. So I need to copy the same formula here as well. See, the individual points, the distribution differs, but the sum of the three values remains constant. So this is something similar to your law of conservation of energy in your physics. Energy can neither be created nor be destroyed. It will keep getting transferred from one form to another form in the system, right? So something like that, the points are neither created nor destroyed. That keeps getting transferred from one party to other party in the system. That's what is happening in this game. So we had done this for 10 iterations, right? So let us further extend it. Let us say for some 20 iterations, what happens? So some values have occurred. So let us take this. Let us even see the sum. See, the sum remains constant irrespective of whatever is the distribution here among the three items. The sum remains constant. So after 20, some sort of convergence, is it occurring? It is. By convergence, I mean between the previous one and the next one, there is no much difference or it exactly remains the same. That is what I mean by convergence. Let us see what happens. When do we get convergence? Let us now fast forward and let us see. I mean, we had checked by 10 iterations, right? First we check for the first 10, then we check for 20. We keep on checking like this. No, so let us check for lot of iterations. Let us see some. Okay, so I have checked for some another 15 iterations. So it appears to converge, but yeah, here it is 119.99, 120 point something, 59.999, 120. It appears to converge. Okay, let us further extend. Let us see what happens. Okay, let us further extend. Let us see what happens. Okay, let me say I'm extending till 140. Wow. See, here there is an exact convergence. 120, 120, 60, 60, 120, 120. And it remains the same. Irrespective of hereafter, how many ever times you repeat, it remains the same. Let us see where this first convergence has occurred. So at the 66th iteration, it was 120, 66, 120. A sort of a stable state has been reached. 67, the same. 68, the same. After that, how many ever times you repeat, the same points distribution is preserved. And if you want to see the sum, let us extend and see. Let us extend and see it. Let us extend and see the sum. All right. So till here. See, the sum was 300 from the beginning till the end. And after some time, the exchange of points keep happening. So see, we initially began with 100, 100, 100 equally. The 300 points were equally distributed to the three parties. They were asked to exchange as per the rule. So the points after one exchange changed. After another exchange, there is further a change in points. So that kept on shuffling. The distribution kept on changing. But irrespective of the distribution, the sum always remained constant. So you can see that the property that has to be observed. And this convergence factor is used in your page rank algorithm. So we had simulated this using the spreadsheet. So let us now get into the programming part and simulate it using our Python programming skills. This will be done in the next part.